Hey guys, so I wanted to film a video today about the skincare products that I'm currently trying out. I haven't done really like a video that kind of covered that, either just favorites or specific reviews, but I've been trying a lot of things out. I know I'm overdue for a skincare routine and a hair care routine and a face routine. I'm overdue for a lot of things, but I figured I'd just let you guys see what I've been trying out since nothing's really settled into a finalized routine yet. I've been all over the place as far as products go because my face has been acting up since like July, and it's getting better. It's definitely controlled now. It's just the oily acne prone skin problem. I think most of it is hormonal because it's literally just in one certain place now. It's like very small pimples. So aside from that, everything I've been using has roughly either kept it under control or made it better. What I've been trying out lately is the Foreo Luna. And I've shown you guys this in my last holiday gift guide, but I had a smaller one. This is the full size. And I've been trying it out with the new day and night cleanser that just released. It's supposed to work hand in hand, kind of like tandemly with the Foreo. And when I tried it, it made a lot of sense to me. I was like, well, do you really have to use it with it? But you do, because when you turn on the Foreo, it vibrates and the scrubbing head of the device just foams up like the cleanser in a weird way. It doesn't get like too sooty, but as you can see in the demonstration, it changes the texture of it and it pretty much like gets the most out of the cleanser. And the cool thing about the day and night cleanser is that the day one is supposed to be the Awakened Radiance Yogurt, and it definitely has a yogurt consistency. It's supposed to, you know, just brighten your skin and, you know, awaken it for the morning, while the nighttime one is the Celestial Melting Gel with meteorite powder. It has little like almost seedweed looking like particles, but that is a part of that powder, and it's supposed to be more soothing because it's nighttime. And it definitely feels more soothing. The scents are a little different. This one is more of a lighter, like refreshing scent, while this one is a calmer, more vanilla-y scent. When I use the day cleanser, it turns into like an airy foam. But when I use the night cleanser, it turns more into like a milky texture, if that makes sense. It doesn't get too sooty. Foreo actually came out with a set that's at Neiman Marcus, and you basically get the cleansers for free because you can get the cleansers and the Luna for $199, and that's pretty much the price of the Luna. So you do get these free, and that to me is a great gift set if you're looking for something for the holidays, because you're pretty much like, you know, you're not losing any money, you're definitely gaining two full size cleansers. Like, this is huge. They're both 3.3 fluid ounces. If you didn't know, it's waterproof and it has a little charging port in the back, and it's just nice and handy. There is a smaller one, like I mentioned. I mentioned in my October favorites that I was using oatmeal, and I still am using oatmeal as much as possible. Aside from trying out new things, this is still like my, I resort back to this. And I use it with just some warm water. I turn it into a milky texture in my hand. This is like quick oats from Quaker Oats, nothing too special, plain. And then when it softens, I just scrub my face with it and I just let it kind of like sit there. And it's really great. A lot of you have tried it out since the October favorites. I've been doing this for years. It's really, really good. And a lot of you guys like Snapchatted me or Instagrammed me about it and were telling me that it's like helped a lot, which I'm so glad, because it's so affordable. I mean, you can get this for like $3 and I am nowhere near finished, and I've been using it for like 2 months now, so it will last you a good amount of time, and that is definitely affordable. Another cleanser I've been trying out is the Neutrogena Oil-Free Acne Wash, which is the pink grapefruit foaming scrub. It definitely foams a little bit, and there's definitely scrub particles in it. I cannot stand the scent personally because I don't like grapefruit, like eating it or smelling it, I guess. It's very, very strong, but I know a lot of people love the grapefruit line inside Neutrogena. I just don't think it's great for me. It's because of the scent, but I can get past that if it was really like doing my face right, if you get what I'm saying. It has a lot of vitamin C in it, and it's supposed to clear blemishes and blackheads, while the gentle microbeads smooth away roughness without over drying your skin. So I'm currently just kind of like, eh, about it. I try it from time to time. I haven't been really seeing anything like particularly different about it, so it's so-so. Next is this Lemon Detox Peeling Gel, and I mentioned this in my Boutique November review. I love this stuff. I wish a little bit went a long way, because you actually need a good amount of it, and I'm probably like a third done already, but it's a really cool gel, which is the type that you use after cleansing your face. You dry your face, and then you massage this in, and it takes all of like the dry skin and like excess, you know, build up on your face skin wise and it turns it into like little balled up gunky particles. It's kind of gross, but so satisfying at the same time. It's satisfying in like a look at your nose strip after you peel it off type of way. And I always have like a lot of dry skin like right here, and that like pisses me off. It drives me nuts because no matter what I do, even when I use my like microdermabrasion stuff, it kind of stays there for a while, only deals with it for a little bit. But when I use this, it completely came off. It's very similar to the Cure Aqua Gel, if you've tried that before, but it has more brightening ingredients because of the lemon. And I really, really like that stuff. Like, it's real stuff, guys. I kid you not. As far as my toner lately, I've been using the spray toner from Dermalogica. It's the Clear Start Toner. And I got this back in the summertime. I used to use the Clear Start line once upon a time. If you go way back in my videos, I want to say like around 2011, I was using like the moisturizer and the cleanser and stuff because my skin was hurting. And I just have been spraying this on my face after cleansing, and sometimes I'll spray it onto like a cotton pad. If you spray too much and you inhale, I cough all the time because it's a very strong scent. I like it. It's not like holy grail status. It has salicylic acid, which is great for my face as far as managing it and controlling it goes. My face really loves salicylic acid. I've said that for years. So I've been using this. I definitely will finish it, but I don't know if I'll repurchase it because again, it's just okay. Another toner I've been dabbling in is the Believe in Truth toner that you can find in Sephora, and this one is for normal combination skin. I finished the oily skin one already months ago, and this one is the herbal extract toner. This is a thicker consistency because it's not for oily skin. The oily skin one literally feels like water, and this feels like a serum that's been watered down just a little bit. So it's a little thicker. It's very nurturing. I like it a lot. It feels really good after a long day on the face, so I like this a little bit more, but again, like, it hasn't been doing anything crazy for me aside from just like prepping my skin for the next product. I've been trying a lot of Believe stuff lately because they sent a bunch of things for me to try. This is the cleansing herb water, and it's very similar to my Bioderma, which I'm almost out of, if you can see. And this is just my usual makeup remover, and this is the combination oily skin formula. This one is supposed to dissolve makeup and remove impurities in a one-step cleanser, and it's supposed to leave your face clear without a oily residue. And it definitely does that. There is no oily residue, and that's what I love about both of these products. I still like to cleanse my face afterwards, but it does a great job in getting everything off. So this, I possibly might repurchase. But a little bit goes a really long way with this because I've been using it on and off, and pretty much looks new. The True Cream Aqua Balm, this moisturizer, is amazing! I saw it in Cosmopolitan earlier when I was at the nail salon. It's in the magazine. And a lot of you guys told me that this was your favorite product from the line. It is pretty nice. It reminds me of a Laneige toner, not toner, moisturizer, like the Water Bank one, but better. It's really nice. A little bit goes a long way, feels really good on skin, and smells super good. So all in all, pretty good stuff. The eye cream, which is the moisturizing and firming eye cream from Believe, a little bit goes a super long way with this, like the tiniest amount, and I like it lately. I wouldn't say it is like doing anything for dark circles, but it definitely feels like it's firming and moisturizing. My eye area looks really good after using it, and I've been using it night and day. It's not too heavy for daytime, which is something I like. And this is one of my favorites for sure too. It's the Hungarian Water Essence. I use this before moisturizer because it dries really fast. It soaks in really, really fast, and for even my face at this time of year, it's not enough. Maybe summertime this might be enough by itself, possibly, I don't know. But it is really nice. It's lightweight and it really makes you feel like your skin is bouncy, if that makes sense. It contains the Hungarian water that's supposed to be a beauty secret that Queen Elizabeth uses, but it's a concentrated serum that's supposed to replenish your moisture levels and leave you youthfully dewy. I would say it leaves you dewy because it sinks in really fast, but it definitely leaves you looking moisturized and youthful. Last two things, kind of fun stuff. Of course, mask. Hello, it's me. This is okay, obviously I got issues today. But this is from my Momoko, and it's the Innisfree Super Volcanic Pore Clay Mask. Innisfree just came out with like a whole volcanic clay set, and I've been dabbling in stuff like that lately. It is a really nice mask. It looks like it lightens your skin a little bit when you wash it off. I'll give you that warning just off the bat. It doesn't like permanently whiten your skin, but like it looks like a little bit lighter once you wash the mask off. I think it's just like maybe like after effect. But I use this and it's super smooth going on. It's so easy to spread. It feels like a really nice like buttery consistency, and then it dries, and then you wash it off after a certain amount of minutes. No complaints there. It, to me, it's supposed to help you with your pores mostly, and it does feel good. It's like a tight mask without being too tight to the point that it's like flaking everywhere when you move your face, because it still has that like nice buttery texture before it dried. So all in all, I like it, and I'll link it off down below. It's been like sold out on and off, so hopefully it's still in stock when this video goes up. Last thing is this new rose gold elixir I saw on Instagram recently. Got it. I swear I got it like 2 days ago, and it's a radiant moisturizer with 24 karat gold in it. It's a beauty oil. I didn't even realize it's gonna have 24 karat gold in it. I'm just a sucker for Instagram posts. I just am. So a lot of people were mixing this in with their foundation and they were looking good. So I was like, you know what, I'm gonna try it. And I didn't even know it was rose gold till it showed up. I got the smaller bottle, the half a fluid ounce bottle. It has vitamin A and E, omega 3, 6, and 9. It's supposed to be really good for your face. And once upon a time, I was really into beauty oils, mostly from Boscia. So I don't mind trying this out. It's a very tiny bottle, but a little bit does go a super long way. And what's cool is when you open it, it literally is like gold on gold. The serum itself, it's like a tinted light yellow, like gold, and it has a bunch of flakes of 24 karat gold in it, and it's really luxurious for sure. I sound crappy, sorry guys. It leaves your skin with almost like, not a sparkly appearance, but definitely a radiant appearance. It leaves like a sheen, like illuminated sheen. So I see why people mix this in with their foundation. It's like a subtle highlighted glow. I've been using it separately and with, I wore it under my foundation today. I'm not seeing like a huge difference, but then again, I went really subtle with it because I didn't want to like overly oil my face. But oily skin can use beauty oils, contrary to popular belief. If you use it correctly, I like to pat it into my hand and then pat it into my face. Do not rub this crap all over your face. You will look like a really, really bad like oil change accident on your face. It's not cute. But like I said, a little bit goes a long way, so like a drop or two is, it's good. It's good. I'm enjoying it, but we'll see how it goes. I don't know if I'll repurchase because it's really expensive. It's gonna really have to make a difference in my face over time, and I've only had it for a couple days, so we will see if it makes it to a later favorites or a skincare routine. That's all of the products that I've been switching up and using right now. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing everything. I'll link off everything down below. If you want to check out the 4-Oil set, it'll be down below, as well as all the mask and all the oatmeal. I mean, I don't know if I have to link off oatmeal, that's a little much. But everything else, like the Belief line that is available at Sephora, will be linked off down below as well. So thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a later video.